didn't see it.
Mm-hmm.
Have fun.
Thanks, you too.
Corruption, violence, exploitation, abuse.
Yeah?
Nobody walks out on me!
Well, sweetheart!
Don't sweat on me, you son of a bitch!
Roxy, please!
Thank you.
want to know what really happened? I shot him. Put that down in your book, palsy. You want to know why? He was trying to walk out on me, the louse.
That's a pretty cold-blooded murder, Mrs. Hart.
They're liable to hang you for that one.
Hang me?
Not so tough anymore now, aren't you?
Amos, did you hear what he said? Son of a bitch! Not you!
wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead. They had it coming! They had it coming!
Thank you.
How much is that phone call gonna cost?
You know how I feel about your family.
I'll do it for 50 bucks.
Oh, 50 bucks for a phone call? You must get a lot of wrong numbers, Mama.
$5,000.
Ladies and gentlemen, a tap dance.
Here's another 700 out of the building and loan fund, and 300 that I got from the guys down at the garage, and 500 out of my insurance.
That's a 2,000.
And that's all I got so far.
Well, what about her father?
Oh, I phoned him yesterday. He said he'll be able to raise some money later.
You're a damn liar. See, I spoke to her father myself. And do you know what he told me? That his daughter went to hell 10 years ago. And that she would stay there forever before he spent a cent to get her out.
Well, I'll give you $20 a week out of my salary. Notes of interest, doubles, triples, till every cent is paid.
It's very touching. But I've got a motto, and that's this. Play square, dead square. Now, when you came to me yesterday, I didn't ask you, was she innocent? I didn't ask you, was she guilty? I didn't ask if she was a drunk or a dope fiend? No sorts of foolish questions like that, now, did I? I just asked you if you had $5,000. And you said you did. But you don't have $5,000, so I figure that makes you a dirty liar.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I took your wife's case, and I'm keeping it. Because I play square. Now listen, Hart, I don't like to blow my own horn, but if Jesus Christ had been in Chicago today and he'd have had $5,000, well, things would have turned out differently. Okay, here's what we're gonna do tomorrow morning. I'll have her name on every front page, making the hottest little jazz hit since Melvin Cabin. Then we announce we're gonna hold an auction to raise funds for her defense. They'll buy everything she's ever touched. Dresses, shoes, underwear. Plus, we tell them that if by due process of law she gets hanged,
hey,
the stuff triples in value. I'll give you 20% of everything we make over $5,000. And that's what I call playing square.
Oh, I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
You see, it's like this. I get the entire $5,000. You rotten Jake, before I bring you to trial. Good. Get that out of your system. You mean one thing to me, $5,000. Got it? Now, in a few moments, it's gonna be a big press conference in here with a whole bunch of photographers and reporters. And that sob sister from the Evening Star is coming. I don't figure we'll have any trouble with her. Her name is Mary Sunshine. pipe down on the swearing. From here on in, you say nothing rougher than oh dear, got it? Good, now the first thing we're gonna do is go after sympathy from the pranks. They're not all bushel wounds like that Mary Sunshine. Chicago's a tough town. In fact, it's gonna be so tough that they shoot the girls right out from under you. But there's one thing that they can never resist, and that is a reformed sinner. So I've decided to rewrite the story of your life from convent to jail. Get this. Southern home, every luxury and refinement. Parents dead, educated with a sacred heart. A fortune swept away, a runaway marriage, a lovely innocent girl, bewildered by the tax. You were young, full of life, lonely. You were drawn to the mad world of a great city.
Yeah.
You get that, Bridget?
Like
Shots. And this we did it.
in jails nowadays. I mean, there was a time you could go to jail and get a really good...
Okay, Roxy, I'll level with you.
Listen, what did Mama just tell you? It's me they want now, huh? Haven't you read the papers? I'm a star. Big star. Single.
Thanks very much.
It's nothing personal. You understand.
Nothing personal.
Nothing's ever personal.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Roxy Hart.